I'm Jane Liu, and I'm an associate professor of chemistry at Pomona College. Pomona College is an undergraduate institution, so we don't have master's students, we don't have graduate students, we don't generally have postdocs. So my research assistants are undergraduates. They do all of the work in the lab. They're the ones pushing our research program forward. Each student always gets their own research project that we sort of develop based on both their interests and the needs of the lab. And they carry it out with me first guiding them, but then usually after a few months, they're really starting to feel comfortable and running the show on their own. My lab studies cholera, and cholera is a disease that affects 3 to 5 million people each year. It's a diarrheal disease that happens when you drink water that's contaminated with the bacteria that causes cholera. The bacterium is called Vibrio cholerae, and so in my lab, we study Vibrio cholerae and what makes it tick, what makes it work, what makes it cause disease. So there's a public health interest. If we can make some progress in this field, it could have the benefit of helping general public health. Given the population at Pomona, a lot of the students who come through the chemistry program, for example, are considering careers in medicine. So I also figured that the disease aspect of the projects would be appealing to undergraduates. We are particularly interested in how these bacteria are able to survive when they're actually outside the human host. How do they survive in their water homes, which is where they hang out until someone then drinks from that water again. And we've found that these bacteria, they are able to sense the surroundings, so what's in the water, and then adapt appropriately. So, for example, they might be able to adapt to certain nutrients that are available and express certain proteins, certain RNAs that allow them to survive and persist, is what we call it, in those watery environments. We know some of the proteins and RNAs involved, but not all of them, and not how exactly everything's connected. So we're still trying to figure that out to then hopefully be able to manipulate the system to decrease cholera burden.